I'm Angela Fisher Hall with the Birmingham Civil Rights Institute. I'm the Vice President of Publications and Special Projects.
Why did you think this was this initiative about coming around and doing public dialogues on the U.S. global role? What attracted you to this for the Civil Rights Institute?
Well, we look for many opportunities here at the Institute to partner with other organizations who want to come in and have dialogue with our community on a variety of issues. There are some things that we initiate here at the Institute. There are others that come as opportunities when folks just simply call us and ask if we're interested in working with them. Here at the Institute, our mission is to promote civil and human rights worldwide through education, and we saw this forum as an opportunity to present a new conversation to the community, to get their feel for how they see the United States on a global scene. And so we want to have an opportunity for our community to just simply have this conversation. And it is not a subject matter that we deal with here at the Institute on a regular basis. So when we were contacted by the Fund for Peace to work with and to provide an opportunity for this forum, we saw it as a good opportunity for us.
Now, the youth that we met with today are obviously, they're working as docents at the museum. This is an exposure for them to civil rights. But you also mentioned that they have a connection on human rights. What do you see as that connection, and what they get out of this?
Well,
youth in general, maybe.
Right. Well, the youth are the ones who really made a change here in Birmingham, Alabama during the 1960s. Struggle for equal justice and equal opportunity in our country. And we think young people had a significant role then, they have a significant role to play today. We think that what happened here in Birmingham showed the power of an individual person to bring about change. And we want our young people to always know that they have the opportunity, they have it within themselves to make change happen in our country and our world. And so they are here as docents, being trained, well, we share with them the history of what happened here in Birmingham. First of all, so they can understand what happened, so they can have an appreciation for what happened, and so that they know that they are part of a community that brought about change around the world, because what happened in Birmingham really did affect and impact human rights struggles worldwide. And for other individuals in other countries to see people like Martin Luther King and Fred Shuttlesworth step out front as individuals who were able to galvanize an entire community, if not a nation, and others felt inspired by all of that. And so we want everyone to understand that Birmingham made a significant change in the world.
What do you think in terms of one of the themes that comes up in these forums is of the sustainability of the way we've been acting in the world and in our roles and our new priorities. So one of the questions is, I guess I have for you, is somebody who educates about social change, is how does this country get ready for a new role on the world stage? If say our power is going to be diminishing or so, how do we accept that? How do we deal with that? And what are your thoughts on that? So social change in that on that level.
I think the most important thing you can do is understand where you come from, and just start there to help people understand what's happening, the role that the United States has played historically on the world scene. And I think with our new president, that he has made people start thinking about all of that. We have really seen a spark in or an increase in our visitorship.
Exactly.
Since our new president was even elected in November last year. And when he was inaugurated and all of that, we've had just a new surge of individuals coming through trying to understand this history, not only of the civil rights struggle, but just in general, American history and where we stand on the global front. And I think it's part of new conversation. So the most important thing that we can do is help members of our country understand who we've been historically, and then just build from there and see what some of the weak spots have been or what they continue to be, and we can build on that as a country.
As well as understand our capacities in a way, too.
And, right, exactly, and understand our capacity and what we're able to do. what financially, what we're able to do, and also just understand what kind of history is, you know, in other parts of the world and other regions of the world as well. So I think that's the best thing we can do, help others understand that history.
Great. Thank you.